Tripoli supplied the answer to a wondering world, once again mystified as to the whereabouts of Mr. Churchill. As his black-painted plane commando came to rest at Castel Benito Aerodrome, Mr. Churchill stepped forward with outstretched hands to warmly congratulate General Montgomery for his splendid achievement, a victory which had altered the whole character of the war. In the picturesque setting of a grassy enclosure bounded by eucalyptus trees, are 2,000 officers and men assembled to receive the thanks of this great man who confidently put his trust in the 8th Army. In his speech to them, Mr. Churchill spoke glowingly of their brilliant achievements. He referred also to the relief which they must have felt in seeing trees and grass and plentiful water after the harshness of the desert. When he had finished, he began to walk away, but General Montgomery called for 3 lusty cheers. And one more. A brilliant sun shone down on Tripoli as down the wide piazza, packed with troops, came the staff cars at the start of the great parade through the city. A wonderful moment in which men of the 51st Highland Division and all the heroes of Libya were represented. And let the New Zealanders never be forgotten in this moment of praise. As the Prime Minister took his place on the saluting base, there came again the stirring music of the pipes, which echoed round the world. Once again the microphones caught their sound and broadcast it to the 4 corners of the earth. The mile-long parade went swinging through the streets.